A new type of control was added to generate a pie or donut chart from a number of connected data points. The control draws one slice for each connected data point using the background color of the data point object. Slices are normally shown clockwise in the order in which the data points are connected to the control, but can also be sorted by size, starting with the largest slice. Each slice can be labeled with the absolute data point value as well as with a relative value, with 100% representing the full pie. By changing the center radius, you can create a donut chart. Also, the background of the hole can be changed. Color map objects provide a new gradient mode. In this mode, the given input values are mapped to the intermediate colors calculated from two or more colors in the color table, instead of mapping the exact color assigned to the interval corresponding to the input value. This can be used to create smooth color transitions without the need to define a lot of color entries. The bar control was extended to support new display modes like stacked or side-by-side bars from a number of connected data points. The side-by-side mode generates a horizontal bar chart from the connected input data points. The control draws one bar per data point from left to right with a configurable spacing between the bars. The stacked mode generates a vertical stacked bar chart from the connected input data points. In order to support a mix of positive and negative input values, the control maintains two separate stacks. One stack contains all positive values and grows bottom up, the other one contains all negative values and grows top down. The bar color mode can be none, single color, or gradient. The last option fills the bar with multiple colors or a color gradient instead of a single color. To do this, a color map object mapping the background color must be connected to the data point. The last selector is related to the display of the value labels for individual bars. A new line break feature was introduced. In controls like text output, line breaks can now be dynamically added. pop-up actions connected to controls provide new options to close when their parent control is hidden. This is useful to automatically close nested pop-ups when their parent pop-up is closed or the parent control becomes invisible due to other reasons. For more information, have a look at the Elvis User Manual.